Okay, I just feel like I have to make this video. I don't know, I just got this rush, and I feel like, I figured something out. I know, I've dealt with a lot of psychological issues. Basically, my story kind of goes like I was laying in bed one day, I had this huge energy, Kundalini awakening, and it basically changed my whole life. I've never been the same since. I've seen UFOs up close and personal multiple times, a dozen times. I've seen angels and demons. I've astral traveled. I've had, lucid dreaming states with aliens. It's total psychological meltdown, followed by extreme clarity, psychic phenomenon, just being more aware. It kind of goes hand in hand. I've gone through states of total confusion and disorientation and loss of reality, followed by such clarity, grounding issues. I mean, man, there was a time when I was, and I'm just still working on it, grounding. I mean, I was trying to ground, but I couldn't. I didn't understand, the physics of it. Because that's that. A lot of people that talk about this stuff are some people that they're just in a dream world. They don't understand that there's math. Physics is everything. This is a physics thing. Auras. That's an electromagnetic field. There's math there, which can be manipulated. There's so much stuff, the mind and how the mind works, and your physical mind, your you can program your brain. A lot of people are aware of that. You can program your energy field. I've heard people talking about programming a Merkaba. I'm not sure. Gianvallo talked about that. I'm not really sure if that's different or not, but the Merkaba meditation is pretty cool too. Interestingly enough, I have amazing experiences with it. At this point, it seems to evade me. It's a little more difficult for me to visualize it for some reason. But before, I would just think about it and bam, I would see it. It's like I didn't have to visualize it with my imagination. It was there, and I guess it was there. I would see it, or however that works. I wrote some stuff down here. Multiple personalities, that's intriguing. Because you don't really quite know what's going on there, Are they just crazy? I'm looking at these videos, MKUltra and stuff like that, and it's like, are they crazy? Is there something to that? I don't know. There's, then there's the black ops secret, military, stuff, the covert programs. Yeah, Men in Black. You got David Icke with the reptilian thing, And so it's like, how do you find clarity, really, and stability with all this information? Stop listening to people, because you got to figure it out yourself. You got to figure out what works for you. I think that it's so specific to each individual person. I think that people are just so unique, really. When you get into this type of world and this type of stuff, I just think they're so different that it's just not, there's not a cut and dry line there. The power of positive thinking. I mean, sometimes I feel great when I'm really pissed off. So, I don't know. I don't know. I know I feel very clear right now. And I know what I know for myself. But the more clarity I have, the less I know. Right now, I'm actually existing in a very expanded state where most things are unknown to me. I look at anything that I know, and I see what I know, but I see that it's a small speck. You know, like what is a ghost? You know, I mean, I've seen ghosts since I was a kid. I don't have the slightest clue what the hell that's all about. You know, and where does that merge in with, you know, think about the Egyptian teachings, you know, the shadow. That's a very interesting thing to explore. And I think for me, you know, I've seen demons, real scary shit, you know, cats, you know, hissing and shit falling off, you know, I can't say that. I have had a couple of, you know, weird paranormal stuff where shit would go flying, but, you know, mainly that's in the mind and emotions, and, you know, and I have seen them, but what is it? You know, that's the, is it really, you know, is this a shadow? Is this my shadow? I think so. I think, you know, self-created demons, I think that's really, you know, for me personally, what it is, even though they do take on a form. You know, I had this experience, I met this woman online, and, you know, we were, I was training astral traveling at the time, and I don't know what happened, but we just decided to meet up, and we had sex, and it was not somewhere else. I mean, I was in my body. I was, like, I went into my body. That, like, to me, that's what astral traveling is. It's like the universe inside me. And I went into my body, and then, like, she came, and it happened, like, to my physical body. I mean, it was crazy. And it blew my whole energy field. Like, I mean, I did something crazy. I felt like we merged into one. And it was the most orgasmic, amazing thing that ever happened. And, I mean, 100 times better than any regular sex I've ever had. I mean, it was crazy. What the hell was that? I don't know. You know, it put me on a path. But, you know, that's all I can say. And I'm here, you know, and I'm looking at these videos, and I always go back to, like, the MKUltra and the Montauk programs. If you haven't heard of the Montauk stuff, it's really interesting. Government experience, dealing with frequency and stuff like that. And I have noticed that, you know, reality is definitely a frequency, state of mind. You know, my mind can create a frequency. But then sometimes, something like Kundalini, I feel like that's almost like a frequency that changes my mind in a way. So I don't know. And that's what makes this easy, is I'm okay with not knowing everything. And because when you know it all, you're stuck. You're in the maze. You're never gonna know it all. So, I think I'm gonna start making these videos and just chatting and just talking about my experience, because I don't know, I just have this urge to do it, and my life is, I mean, I'm running I'm 25, running a small business, and sometimes I feel like, what the fuck am I doing? You know, like, I don't care about money. I mean, really, I mean, I have huge dreams. I really do. I mean, I have an apartment complex back here on the wall. That's, you know, a cheap goal, you know? It's like, that's where I'm headed, but it doesn't have any substance. It really doesn't. It's like, it's for the birds. You know, I feel like this right here is what really intrigues me, the nature of reality. Because, you know, I've created whole realities that were not real. And, you know, I've created total hell before. And I've had to die, physiologically, I had to just die. It was like a living death, and I had to start over totally. I had to forget everything I knew, and I had to start from ground one, because I was lost. And I feel like talking about it, maybe I can offer a perspective to someone out there who's, you know, experiencing a lot of trauma, depression, confusion, anxiety, dissatisfaction. You know, that was, those were mine. Those were like grounding issues. You know, I haven't really felt a lot of hate. But I've gotten into a place, just even as a few days ago, where I was like, you know, this isn't real. You know, I'm in a dream. You know, and that's a very real place that you can be mentally. And it has its benefits. But if it's not balanced with substantial evidence, facts, physics, science, this is a science, this is an art form. And it is mastered by some, right? Because that's the two things. We have academic, right? There's the academic approach where we want to understand the nature of reality and the nature of psychic abilities. And but then there's also the application of that, right? Because you ultimately want to use knowledge for power, right? You want to take what you've experienced psychically, mentally, whatever you want to call it, and use it here, right? Ground, right? This is what they say. Well, ground that information, ground out, and so you can create what you want, right? That's a tall order, I gotta tell you. I know. I feel that's a tall order. And I feel like I feel pretty good about what I'm doing. I feel good about my ability to create, but, you know, I am not even close to where I want to be. So, yeah. That's what it is. So, see y'all on the next one.